Hi friends, I welcome you all to today's discussion with regard to finance related current affairs for upcoming RBI Grade B and SEBI Grade A examination. Now, the topic which we are going to discuss today is the recently released report of the internal working group of RBI on regulatory and supervisory framework for CICs, that is the core investment companies. So we are going to discuss this particular report in the form of MCQs in this video. Now, if you are a paid subscriber of our courses, you need not watch this video again and you can simply watch the entire discussion on this report along with the MCQs in your course itself. Now, before proceeding forward, let me quickly tell you about the excellent results that we have achieved over the past few years. Now, in 2017, in RBI Grade B, we had 27 final selections from our students. And in ABAD Grade A, we had 11 final selections from our students. And in 2018, we repeated the same success story. And in RBI Grade B, we had 70 plus final selections. And in ABAD Grade A, we had 26 final selections. Also, in 2018 SEBI Grade A examination, out of the total 84 selections, 41 of our students, they made it to the final list. And in the IBPS AFO examination, our students have got 100 plus interview calls. Now, if I talk about the different individual courses that we are providing, then they include RBI Grade B, SEBI Grade A, NABARD Grade A, RBI Assistant and IBPS AFO examinations. Now, apart from running the separate courses for all those individual examinations, we are also having some combo courses which you can avail. So we have a combo for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A and SEBI Grade A. We are also having a combo for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A, SEBI Grade A, RBI Grade B and NABARD Grade A and SEBI Grade A. So we have all the requisite combos that you can choose from and you can choose the appropriate course as per your requirements. Let me also tell you about our new course, which is very important for all the banking exams. This is the QRE course. QRE, that is Quantitative Aptitude, Reasoning Ability and English. So all these aspects which are very important for all the banking exams, they are going to be covered in this particular course. So now let's start our discussion on the MCQs, which can be framed out of this particular new topic. First question. Reserve Bank of India had constituted a working group to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for core investment companies on 3rd July 2019. It was chaired by. Options are Shri Tapan Ray, Shrimati Lili Vadera, Shri Amarjeet Singh, Shri N.S. Venkatesh. Now friends, in this regard, we have to remember that RBI on 3rd July 2019 constituted a working group, and this working group was constituted with the objective to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for the core investment companies. Now, this working group, it was chaired by former Secretary, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Government of India, and this is Mr. Tapan Ray. Now, this working group has also recently submitted its report to the Governor of Reserve Bank of India, RBI, and this working group examined the current regulatory and supervisory framework for core investment companies with a view to identify and suggest the measures for limiting the risks which are posed by the core investment companies. So this group was basically concerned with examining the regulatory and supervisory framework and to minimize the risks which are associated with these kinds of investment companies. So now we can easily answer this one, that this working group constituted by RBI, it was chaired by Shri Tapan Ray. So option one is clearly the answer here. Next question. Which of the following is incorrect about core investment company? Options are, core investment company is a banking company which carries on the business of acquisition of shares and securities. It holds not less than 90% of its net assets in the form of investment in equity shares, preference shares, bonds, debentures, debt or loans in group companies. The investments in equity shares in group companies constitutes not less than 60% of its net assets. None is true. So this question is basically asking us about this concept or definition part of the core investment company. So friends, first or foremost, we must remember that this core Investment company is a type of non-banking financial company. So this one is a type of NBFC. Now this NBFC is in the business of acquisition of shares and securities, but this is different from the other NBFCs which are dealing in investments because it is holding less, not less than 90%. So at least 90% of its total net assets, they are going to be in the form of investments. So this is an investment company, 90% assets in investment, it makes sense. But then again, here is the twist. 90% is to be invested in equity shares, preference shares, bonds, debentures, debt or loans in group companies. So this is the true picture here. So further investment in equity shares in group companies constitutes not less than 60% of its net assets. So now we believe, now we remember that 90% of its assets is to be in the form of investment in group companies, and this investment can be in any of these securities. But 60% has to be in the form of equity shares. So this is something which has to be taken care of. Now, if we take a look at the relevance of this concept or how this concept evolved, now the earliest reference to this concept of core investment companies can be traced back to 2002. When core investment companies were identified as investment companies whose only business was to invest in companies for the purpose of holding stake and were not trading in these securities. So I believe you have understood this concept that these companies, they are primarily constituted to hold a stake in the group companies. So suppose there is a very big group like Reliance. Now this group is going to have lots and lots of companies. So let's form a company which is going to have investment in all these companies. So this is basically going to be the investment company which is going to be holding the majority stake in all of these companies. It is going to hold the shares, but it is not in the business of continuously selling and purchasing their shares. It is simply holding those shares. So now we can easily answer this question that the core investment company is a non-banking financial company, not a banking company. So clearly option number one is incorrect here and becomes our answer. Next question. Reserve Bank of India had constituted a working group to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for core investment companies on 3rd July 2019. Which of the following is are the terms of reference of the group? Options are to examine the current regulatory framework for core investment companies in terms of adequacy, efficacy, and effectiveness of every component thereof. To suggest the measures to strengthen corporate governance and disclosure requirements for core investment companies, to assess the adequacy of supervisory returns submitted by the core investment companies and suggest changes therein, all of the above. So this question is asking about the terms of reference of the working group constituted by RBI with regard to the core investment companies. So now if you look at the terms of reference of this particular working group, which was set up by RBI. Now this working group, it was set up to examine the current regulatory framework for core investment companies in terms of adequacy, efficacy and effectiveness of every component thereof and suggest changes therein. So basically we are going to examine the regulatory framework, the regulations which are there for core investment companies. We have to examine and suggest if any changes they are needed. Then we have to assess the appropriateness of and suggest changes to the current approach of Reserve Bank of India towards registration of core investment companies, including the practice of multiple core investment companies being allowed within a group. So we have to also assess the appropriateness of this particular aspect. Next is to suggest measures to strengthen corporate governance and disclosure requirements for core investment companies. Then is to assess the adequacy of supervisory returns submitted by the core investment companies and suggest changes therein. And then is to suggest appropriate measures to enhance the RBI's off-site surveillance and on-site supervision over the core investment companies. So these all are the terms of reference of this particular working group. So now we can easily answer this question. That all of these, they are the terms of reference of this particular group. So clearly the answer to this question is option number 4. Now let's move on to the next question. Reserve Bank of India had recently constituted a working group to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for core investment companies. Which of the following is not one of the 6 major issues identified by the group which require to be addressed? Options are complex group structure, multiple gearing and excess leveraging, lack of proper definition of core investment companies, review of the exempt category and registration. Now friends, this working group, it identified six major issues with regard to the core investment companies. Now what are these six major issues? Now first one is complex group structure, number of layers of core investment companies in a group. So it was concerned with how many companies there can be in a particular group structure. Can there be like more than two or three companies, or there can be a set of huge number of companies in a particular group. So this was something about the complexity in the group structure. Then was multiple gearing and excess leveraging. Now, if there are going to be large number of companies in the group, then these companies, they are going to make use of debt. And this debt refers to leveraging. So this has been one of the concerns. Next is buildup of high leverage and other risks at group level. So this one is again linked to the use of high debt. Then is corporate governance. So the corporate governance framework is also one of the concerns raised by the working group. Then is the review of the exempt category and registration part. So then one of the major issues identified was that whether there should be any category which was to be exempt from the different sorts of regulations, and what is to be the registration threshold for the core investment companies. Then is enhancing offsite surveillance and on-site supervision over the core investment companies. So we must find ways that we enhance supervision over these core investment companies. So these were the six major issues identified by the working group. So now clearly we can answer this question that option number three is the one which is not one of the six major issues identified by the working group. All other issues, they are the ones which have been identified as discussed on the previous slide. Next question. Reserve Bank of India had recently constituted a working group to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for core investment companies. Which of the following is not one of the recommendations of the group? Options are, the number of layers of core investment companies in a group should not exceed 2. Offsite returns may be designed by the RBI and prescribed for the core investment companies on the lines of other NBFCs. Introduction of a new category of exempted core investment companies by RBI. All of the above are recommendations of the group. So this is now with regard to the recommendations of this working group. So now let's take a look at the key recommendations which have been made by this working group. So first one is, the number of layers in a core investment company should be restricted to 2. Now there can be a case where there can be a number of investment companies in a group. So it says that the number of layers should not be more than 2. So there can be one investment company at the top, it can hold shares of another investment company, then it can hold shares on the other investment company. So this layers have been restricted to 2 only and not more than 2, because increasing the layers can make the group structures more complex, which was one of the concerns raised by the working group. Then is altering the definition of adjusted net worth to check excessive leverage. So if you are comfortable with the ratio analysis part, you would easily understand that your net worth is one which would determine how much quantum of debt you can take so as to come up with a considerable debt equity ratio. So if we alter the definition of the adjusted net worth, then basically we can check the excessive use of debt or excessive leverage. So this is one of the recommendations. Then is that every group having a core investment company should have a group risk management committee, which would basically be concerned with the risks, and it should also have a board level committees, including audit committee, nomination and remuneration committee. So these committees should be made mandatory as per the recommendations. Then it says that offsite returns may be designed by the Reserve Bank and may be prescribed for the core investment companies on the lines of other NBFCs. So these core investment companies should be mandated to file regular returns with the RBI. Then is annual submission of statutory auditor certificates may also be mandated. Then is on-site inspection of core investment companies may be conducted periodically. So these are all the key recommendations made by this particular committee. So friends, now we can easily answer this question that the third option, which is introduction of a new category of exempted core investment companies by RBI, is not one of the recommendations of this particular group. So clearly this is going to be our answer for this question. So guys, this was all about our discussion. If you are having any query, you can mail us at hello@edutap.co.in, or you can reach us at 8146207241. You can call us or you can WhatsApp us. And I would also recommend that you visit our website www.edutap.co.in for regular updates and important content on the respective examinations. Thank you guys. I wish you happy learning and all the best from the entire team.